5 years. We are from EQ International Magazine, and today we have Mr. Surender Pal Singh with us from Premier Solar. Hello, sir.
Good afternoon, Neha.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, can you just brief about Premier Solar, what it is all about, and about the vision and mission of your company?
We had started solar in 1995 as a system integrator, and then we got into manufacturing solar modules. Over a period today, presently, we have a module manufacturing capacity of 500 megawatt. We also have a solar cell manufacturing of 50 megawatt. We are going in for an expansion as a mega infra project in Telangana. The government has allotted us 10 acres of land in Electronic Park, and we are adding another 5,500 megawatt of solar module manufacturing line. With this, our capacity would be 1 gigawatt of module manufacturing line.
So what are the achievements and innovations and the projects being undertaken as of now?
We have been very active in solar water pumping. Probably we are the number one in the country, having installed close to 20,000 solar water pumps for irrigation and drinking water. We have been very active in rooftop. We have electrified over 350 remote and inaccessible villages in the states of Andhra, Telangana, Madhya Pradesh and UP. This project of ours was recognized by Renewable Energy World USA as the best international project in 2014. These villages are where we provide stand-alone electric power plant. That is, there is a control room, and we give individual connections to every house, and we also provide community lighting like street light for the villagers. These are the villagers who had never seen electricity, so first time they came in contact with power is the solar power.
So can you sir, brief about more about the products you have exhibit over here, and about its technology and any new launches?
Basically, we are a solar module manufacturer. We make poly and mono modules. We have developed glass-to-glass modules which are used for bifacial buildings. We are almost on the process of finalizing flexible solar panels, which will have very wide application for solar e-vehicles and even defense and army. These flexible modules are very light in weight, and we can fold these modules, and they are very, very handy in remote areas.
So sir, how much solar modules you have supplied till now, and what is the target for 2019?
In last 23 years, we would have supplied over 1000 megawatt. That is because earlier our capacity was 50 megawatt, then 200 and 300. Today it is 500. In the next 1 year, we will have 1000 megawatt, that is 1 gigawatt of solar module manufacturing line by the end of this year, December. Hopefully in a year or two later, we are setting up backward integration, a full-fledged solar cell manufacturing line of 500 megawatt. And later on, we also want to manufacture solar wafers.
What are the opportunities and the challenges we have in Indian solar market?
You see, till very recently, the threat was only from China and Taiwan. You would be aware that Government of India has announced safeguard duty against import from China, Taiwan, Malaysia and many other countries. So we hope that now this competition will be reduced. The competition was not only on the pricing, it was because of inferior quality. But as a buyer, people were getting carried away because they were able to get the panel at a cheaper price. So that would stop. And then there's enough incentive to the Chinese manufacturers for export. They get a government subsidy of as high as 14 to 17% of the price as export subsidy. Same thing in India, is just about 1.5%. If I want to export, the cash subsidy for export, what I get from government of India, is just about 1.5%. The cost of fund is very high in India. We pay anything between 11 to 13% per annum on the funds, whereas in China and many other countries, the cost of fund is very low. And the recent big hit is the foreign exchange, the dollar, rupee depreciating against the dollar. It is close to touching 73 rupees a dollar, which is very, very high. We would have some minor advantage on export pricing because we will be able to give a competitive price. But still today we are importing wafers, we import cells, we import glass from China. So we will definitely be helped. The price of solar panel will go up anything from 15% to 20% higher in next couple of months because of the dollar fluctuation, but because of the safeguard duty enforced by Government of India.
What are projects are in pipeline of yours?
So we are very active, as I said, in home lighting systems. We are very active in water pumping. This year alone, we would be installing close to 10,000 solar water pumping system in one single year, which probably again would be a record in the country. We are very, very active in home lighting. We are very active in rooftop. As well, we are EPC contractors for megawatt level ground manufacturing units. Our subsidiary, Premier Solar PowerTech, which we are holding 51% share, has bagged 100 megawatt of EPC contract for solar module power plant, ground mounted, from Navelli Lignite, which we are starting the implementation very shortly.
So at last, what would you like to say about UQ Magazine as it has completed 10 years? So a few words for EQ Magazine.
Yeah, we have been associated with the EQ Magazine. And very, very recent incident that Premier Solar had the privilege of being the first manufacturing company in India to be certified by BIS, and it was EQ International just flashed the news in a couple of hours, I would say, or even less than that, and we got an extensive response from our competitors and our players that they came to know from EQ that Premier is the first company to get a BIS license.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for being with us.
My pleasure. Thank you very much, Tisha.